technical problems. So I would speak to you today about the sort of avoidance section, about how it can be used in mathematics education. So then, what is the avoidance section puzzle? This is a puzzle which is partly a toy to play for children or adults, and this is a very good teaching aid for different age of pupils, which can use the by bus teachers in the classroom. When you apply for a registration of a patent, the patent office always asks you to compare it with something similar, older version of think in this case for a puzzle. You can compare, you must compare it with something else. So I brought one older example, what is similar to that older tangram. This is the tangram. The tangram is a very old brother of the golden section puzzle. It is about approximately 2,600 years old. Originates from China. The tangram consists of seven pieces, and two of these pieces are identical in shape. There are sold different kinds of tangrams. Which are made in one color. There are in seven colors. There are such tangrams where the identical shapes are colored in the same color, and so on and so on. And the first problem is if you mingle these tiles, how short time can one make this square of the seven pieces? But it is useful also to make different shapes, and there are many thousands of shapes which can be placed from the seven dice. The mathematics of the tangram is developing for more than 2.5 millennium. It is surprising that it was shown only 70 years ago that there is possible to make only 13 convex shapes of the tangram tiles, which is a surprising low figure, and the proof the existence of this number of figures took many years and work of mathematicians. Of course, you can make several other shapes from the tangram. The numbers are many thousands, and if you use different colors, you can make much more and more tiles of the tangram. So let us turn to the golden section puzzle, which works in a similar principle, but it shapes not a square, rather a golden section rectangle. So this white shape is a golden rectangle. Why is it golden? Because the proportion of its edges is equal to the golden section, which is 1.618 and so on to the infinity. I do not want now go into the details, because almost all of you know what is the golden section and the golden section. The golden rectangle has different interesting properties. The most important is that if you divide it into two parts, so that one part would be square, then the rest rectangle will be similar to the original one. And you can continue this because if the right side is a similar golden rectangle, you can divide it also into a square and another golden rectangle, and you can do it up to the infinity, but we will not continue. We will cut to the original golden rectangle into these three parts. And we can use the diagonals of the golden rectangle as well. So we can cut it according to the main diagonal of the original and we can cut according to the diagonal of the second rectangle. So with these four cuts, we have got eight dice. We divided the original golden into eight parts. Of course, we could continue further, but it proved to be the most appropriate to make a good toy and a good mathematics education teaching aid. You can place these tiles, the tiles in different ways. For example, you can use these three, which are shown in this picture, and you can color them in different ways with different colors, and so on. You can use three, four, more. Up to eight colors. You can use only two colors, black and white, or you can use two colors of the others, which are different or opposite colors of each other. And you can make tiles with the golden section puzzle. For example, there are three such tiles, or another where there are not marked the original dividing lines. And you can make similar tilings with different colors. You can tile the golden rectangle with several colors, more, less, using the white tiles as well, and leaving the white tiles place empty, and so on. Many one can calculate how many combinations are possible from different colors if you give a certain number of the colors. Now the gray mark, so those tiles who are left from the tiling, and you can make different shapes. You can use not only one set of the eight tiles, but you can use, for example, four, less or more sets of the tiles and make larger shapes of them. So, let's go back to this tile. You see here three colors, white, blue, and red. And we can use for the tiling eight colors. If we use eight colors, then we will get a set of the tiles, 8 times 8, 64 tiles, and this is what a single set of the tiles contains. I brought an example for you, and these are the 8 colors that I use. So there is the black and the white, and you can use them so that the black is the main color and the white in the opposite side, but you can use the white color as the first side and the black in the opposite side. And you can use also these six other colors. I will speak later about these colors again. Why do we need to separate the sets where the black is the first color and where the white is the first side color? Because they are chiral. So if you turn this, these are not identical when you make a tiling. So cannot use this one for tie the golden rectangle for which you need this element of the set of the tiling. This is why we can form eight sets from the of the eight colors used. I will return to the colors later when I explain you what are the possibilities to apply this tiling and the set of ties in mathematics education. First, you can learn the Fibonacci numbers and their attitudes when you explain to the children why is this golden rectangle cut in these ties, and what is the number of the Fibonacci proportion, how we get it, how is it in connection with the Fibonacci series, and so on. So many kinds of mathematical knowledge can be given to the children according to their age. You can learn the concept of the golden section and its relation to the Fibonacci numbers, and I told. And you can you teach the children to measure. You measure with a ruler which consists of not equal centimeters, but which ruler is the edges of the ruler correspond according to the golden section number and its powers. For example, the zero power is the unit, and minus two, minus three powers, which correspond to the edges of the different ties belonging to the set. Further, you can learn what is similitude, because there are different ties among the one set of the golden section puzzle. So you can find three trapezoids and five triangles, and the five triangles and the three trapezoids separately are similar to each other with similar proportions like the golden rectangles according to which we cut the original golden rectangle. You can learn in a similar way the proportionality, the notion of proportionality according to the golden section, but it can be applied, of course, to other proportions as well. It helps only for the children to understand the meaning. You can compare different appearances of symmetries. I teach at the Budapest University and earlier at other universities symmetry, a full semester course. The 15 lectures of my course are published in this book in English. And there are presented hundreds of examples of the different applications of symmetry in this book during this course. But for the general school children, the basic forms of symmetries are important, which can be studied with this golden section puzzle. For example, first of all, the mirror reflection. If you ask the children what does symmetry means for them, 80% or more of them will just tell you that it is mirror reflection. A small part will tell you that it is rotation is also symmetry, but none of them will mention the other force of symmetry. Why is similitude also a symmetry, translation and symmetry, permutation and symmetry, color symmetry, which is the first form, which is not a geometric symmetry, and a good example which can introduce them not only into the art, in symmetries in the arts, but into the symmetries in the sciences, for example, in physics and chemistry, and so on. So the study of symmetries with the use of this golden section puzzle is a very important part of this series, what is it good for. You can teach the children how they can study on this tiling of the golden rectangle, a few theorems of the right triangles, for example, the Pythagorean theorem, the eight theorem, because they can be exemplified with the help of these ties, and they can try themselves without calculating and solving equations and proving with the tools of Euclidean geometry, but puzzling, placing the ties one to the other and prove this theorems experimentally. They can study combinatorics by tiling with shapes. This is for higher grade pupils, with shapes and colors. For example, why cannot they solve the problem to place to tile the golden rectangle so that the neighbor of each tile would be another color if you use only two colors? And you can explain them that because in the golden section rectangle there are nodes which contain in which odd and others in which even edges meet, and this is a very similar problem like Euler's problem about the very famous Königsberg bridges problem. I have no time to mention, but I hope many of you know what is this basic problem of combinatorics and graph theory as well, which can be introduced not only at university level, but in general school children as well by the help of this tie. You can study the attributes of the basic colors, and here I should make a stop to explain why the colors of the golden section puzzle are chosen in this way. So when we study the colors, we use the so-called golden color cube. One of the edges is marked by coordinates of 0, 0, 0, and according to our computer color system, the opposite edge is marked by 255. So the scale is 256 units long, and since the black color is colorless, so we name this this node to the black, and the opposite, the full color, which contains all the full colors, it is the white. And there are the three axes, the red, the green, and the... Excuse me. It works, yes? So, no?
No need.
Maybe I broke it.
Can I have?
Thank you very much. So, the first on the red edge is the red, the green, the blue, and these are the so-called basic colors. These are used, for example, in the TV colors decoding or my computer screen decoding. And the three others are the opposite colors of them. So these are called the cyan. You don't see because it is too dark. The cyan, the magenta, and the yellow correspond to the rest three edges. So if you see the coordinates, the opposite of the red color is the cyan. The opposite color of the green is the magenta, and the opposite color of the blue is the yellow. This is why the opposite sides of the tiles are made of the opposite colors. I will not show all them, but you can imagine them in this way. So this is an application. How can you define an arbitrary color with the three? You can mark them with the three coordinates, and you can mark any arbitrary color with the three coordinates in this color cube. So this is very suitable to explain the children. What are the symmetries and what is the order in the colors in the RGB system, which is used in our screens, and in the cyan, magenta, yellow, which are used by our printers. The next possibility to study, and I will finish soon, studying harmony by means of proportions, both in the geometry and the arts. You can bring many examples from, say, studying harmony by means of the colors, also both in geometry and in the arts. Studying the phenomenon of chirality, which is applicable in chemistry and biology, as I showed, why we need two sets from the two colors, two same colors. And the children, the younger one, may play domino with these ties. There are several coinciding edges among the ties, and they can find different ways and rules for playing a domino with one color or with several colors, how they can fit the edges into each other. They can tie different shapes, like from the tangram, from this kind, the children can shape figures, so that you tell them that let's make a human body from the ties, but you can allow the children to use their own fantasy, and they will find different shapes which you never would find out, because the variations are very high. And finally, you can construct shapes similar to the tangram freely. So that's all the possibilities. The time is over, but if you have your questions, I can answer you and show you some types of this. Thank you.